Hello, good day everyone. This is Tefs. Welcome back to this channel. This next repair is an Epivir Triron 4210 MPPT solar charge controller. Not turning on and not charging. I will show you how to fix it. If you are a beginner in repairing TVs and other electronic gadgets, you are on the right channel. So don't forget to like, share and subscribe. You can also ring the notification bell to never miss a video like this. So let's get started. This device is used to charge a battery using solar panels. Let's open it and see what is the problem. It looks like it's been repaired before. Let's test the fuses. They are blown. That is the reason why it is not turning on. But there is also a reason why the fuse is blown. Let's unscrew the circuit board. Let's test the power MOSFETs. The multimeter sets to continuity, and beep means short circuit. Seems some of the MOSFETs are shorted. Let's desolder the MOSFETs.
Power nya bagian inok nya agli dem ya kapas itu memang apa kamu tak open line di cellphone.
N10F is a 150 ampere drain to source, with a maximum voltage of 100 volts. This one is a diode. Let's continue to remove the other MOSFETs. This is also shorted. This is a MPPT solar charge controller. MPPT stands for maximum power point tracking, with the maximum charge conversion efficiency of up to 98%. There are 4 MOSFETs for the DC to DC conversion at 40 amps of charging power. This is the diode and it seems is not shorted. Done desoldering all shorted MOSFETs. We will solder back the diode because it is not defective.
Several days later.
I buy this MOSFET online from China. Not a similar part number but similar in number codes. This will work hopefully. Let's solder the new MOSFETs. Thank you. Next, now desolder the two fuses and replace them. The fuse terminals are too long, and the heat sink is gonna touch them, so trim it a bit. Now, all necessary components are replaced. Replace also this insulator. If you wondering what is this? This is a LiFePO4 battery, 4 cells 3.2 volts each equal to 12.8 volts more than 13 volts when full charge. I will use this to test the MPPT charge controller. The charge controller is now turned on. But it will be charging? I will connect it to my solar panel to see if it will charge. It's charging about 24 amps to the battery. And 11 amps from the solar panels. The MPPT solar charge controller is working now. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed my video. If you just did, then make sure to like, share, and subscribe. You can also hit the notification bell to keep you updated. Once again, I'm Tefs. See you again next time. Bye for now.
Wow, lihat.
Kamu sih nanti di kapit.